Hello friends, welcome back to Friend of Health. So today, this is the fourth episode of UPSC series by Friend of Health for the preparation of medical officer, research officer and general duty medical officer homeopathy. So we have the exam date in our hand. So exam will be on December 20th and the reporting time in the exam center is 8 a.m. and exam will be held for 2 hours from 9:30 a.m. to 11:30 a.m. And as of now, we are not sure about the number of questions, but we assume that it may be 100 questions because they have given the total marks is 300 and 1/3 will be reduced as a negative mark for each question. So we assume that 100 may be the number of questions. So we will go to our fourth episode. So hope you have seen the first part of the Metrio Medica discussion or the 10 questions from the 2016 UPSC question paper and the 20 questions from the repertory questions of 2016 and 2017 UPSC exam. So this episode will contain again 10 more questions from the 2016 UPSC. Total 46 questions were there, and in 2017 30 questions were there. So we'll try to upload the remaining questions from Metrio Medica as early as possible. So follow our channel. If you have not subscribed, subscribe and enable the bell icon so that you will get the notifications as soon as we post the video in our channel. So today again 10 more questions from UPSC 2016 medical officer homeopathy exam we will discuss. We will see the first question, that is 11th question from Metrio Medica session. Afraid of society is a symptom of Lachesis, Platina, Cicuta virosa, Naxomica. Answer is Cicuta virosa. So these are direct questions, but the problem with this question is this symptom is not found in Boric Metrio Medica or in Alan's keynotes. So you have to refer James Taylor Kent for that. So this is the issue with UPSC preparation. You may not be able to answer every question if you prepare just Boric Metrio Medica and Alan's keynote alone. So you have to prepare from Nash, from James Taylor Kent, from ML Taylor, such Clark's Dictionary of Metrio Medica. So such Metrio Medica also you have to prepare. So the best option is, as I have mentioned in the earlier how to plan your Alan's keynote preparation in 44 days, that video I have clearly mentioned. Whenever you read a Metrio Medica drug from Alan's keynote, simultaneously you read from Boric Metrio Medica, Clark's Metrio Medica, also you prepare from Nash, James Taylor Kent and ML Taylor. So these Metrio Medicas, if you read, you can get the wonderful symptoms and you can conquer the toughest exams also. So recently in 2020 AAPGT, if you see, there are questions from Nash Metrio Medica, ML Taylor Metrio Medica, etc. So this dislike to society, or here you can see he is afraid of society. So afraid of society, Cicuta virosa. So afraid of company, wants to be alone. This is a question, and he is afraid of society. We'll see the 12th question from Metrio Medica session. In which one of the following drugs porigo capitis is a symptom? So answer is Calcarea muriaticum. So Calcarea muriaticum, this symptom you can find in the relationship part of the drug Calcarea carb in William Boric's Metrio Medica. So William Boric's Metrio Medica, first paragraph is very very important. The italic symptoms are very very important. The sensations, the peculiar sensations are very very important. And the most important part is the relationship part. The relationship part, if you see the 2019 AAPGT, you can see this question. When Pulsatilla failed in schoolgirls, which remedy to be prescribed according to William Boric? This question I have already discussed in the how to prepare Boric's Metrio Medica for AAPGET. So that video will be definitely helpful for you who are preparing for UPSC also, because Boric's Metrio Medica, how to prepare, from where and all questions can be framed, everything I have detailed there. While I was discussing this 2019 AAPGET question, I have already mentioned about this Calcarea Mur question also, because in the comparison session of Calcarea Carb, Calcarea Mur also, this question, the porigo capitis, this appeared in 2016 UPSC as we are discussing now. This I have already mentioned in that video. So you can watch that video also for getting a clear idea how to prepare Boric's Metrio Medica. So porigo capitis, Calcarea Mur, you can find it in the relationship part of the Calcarea Carb remedy. The drug which has numbness of lower limbs after passage of stool So these are symptoms which are very direct, and if you prepare and if you revise, you can answer these very easily. Otherwise also, when some rare remedies are there in the options, like Calicarb, Opium, Sepia, other than that one rare remedy when it appears, you can directly give a guesswork if you are not sure also, because whenever there is only one rare remedy, mostly that will be the answer. This is not a generalization, but these are some hacks of the exam, MCQ exam. So, Triostium perfoliatum. This is the answer here. If you see the Borix Materia Medica, the first paragraph itself, the very important first paragraph itself of Triostium perfoliatum, you can see the fever root. This is a very interesting common name, fever root. Triostium perfoliatum, fever root. So, Triostium is a very valuable remedy in diarrhea attended with colicky pains and nausea, numbness of lower limbs and after stool. This was the question. And this is there in the first line itself. So, this first paragraph of every remedy, you have to read and you have to revise it for keeping it fresh in your memory, and do multiple revisions, and you can score all 100% from the Borix Materia Medica session if you do this first paragraph and the italic symptoms and the important symptoms, the important sensations and the relationship part from Borix Materia Medica. The 14th question from Materia Medica in 2016 question paper. Aggravation about neck area from contact of clothing is a symptom present in all except. The question is about aggravation about neck area from contact of clothing. So here they want except which remedy doesn't cover this symptom. So glonoin, lachesis, sepia and natremur are there in the option. Answer here is natremur. If you see the Materia Medica, Allen's keynote Materia Medica, sepia remedy, you can see this symptom. All the coverings of the neck felt too tight and were constantly loosened. So, lachesis. Lachesis is the in bracket means sepia and lachesis is the remedies covering for that according to Allen's keynote. So, if you see homeopathy Materia Medica by William Borick, glonoin, you can see in the throat session, neck feels full, collars must be opened. So, these three remedies are there. So, whenever you see such similar symptoms or close running symptoms, you can mention in the Allen's keynote itself, as you will be revising Allen's keynote from the textbook itself many times. Otherwise, you can make such interesting symptoms or similarly running symptoms in a notebook, and you can revise that notebook. So, these three remedies, sepia, lachesis and glonoin. This is the answer. Neck feels full, collars must be open, glonoin. All the coverings of neck feel too tight and were constantly loosened, lachesis. Vertigo on ascending is a symptom of which one of the following drugs? So, vertigo on ascending, answer is Calcarea Carb. Gelsimium, Ferrometallicum, Coffea Cruda are also there in the options. But these are luckily not very confusing or very tricky options, because they are not so close running with Calcarea Carb in such a symptom. But sometimes these similar modalities of or confusing modalities, they can make in the option, so that question will become little more tougher. So here Calcarea Carb, if you see in the Borix Materia Medica in head session, you can see vertigo on ascending and when turning the head. So vertigo on ascending, Calcarea Carb. The 16th question, Myrtol, an active antiseptic, is present in the leaves of which one of the following drugs? Answer is Myrtus communis. So, you can see the first line itself in Borix Materia Medica, first paragraph, very, very important. Myrtle is a common name, and the leaves contain myrtol, an active antiseptic. The leaves contain myrtol, an active antiseptic. Some other important and interesting symptoms are also there. You have to go through these kind of rare remedies also from Borix multiple times. We'll see the 17th question from Materia Medica in 2016 UPSC. Intense itching without eruption is a symptom of which one of the following drugs? Very, very, very repeatedly asked question. It is very easy because it is very much repeated, and you might have gone through many question papers of various competitive examinations. And this answer is Dolichos Puriens. Intense itching without eruption. So, itching without eruption, Dolichos. And very close running, this is a symptom, a general intense itching without eruption, Dolichos. Cowhage. This is the common name, cowhage, and William Borick in the first paragraph itself, general intense itching without eruption. If you see the very close running cicuta virosa, eczema, no itching. So itching will not be there, but eczema will be there. That is going for cicuta. And this question, this particular line, eczema, no itching, exudation forms into a hard lemon colored crust. This line appeared in as a question in the same question paper. We will come to that in the next episodes. So this question was there in the same question paper. So one who have studied these symptoms by comparing like eczema, no itching, cicuta, and itching, intense itching without eruption, dolichos, those people can answer both the questions in a same question paper. So whenever you prepare, compare with the close running or the opposite symptoms, and also the facts in the medicine subject, practice of medicine also, very close running diagnosis or very close running investigations, findings, everything you have to compare and study. 18th question. Always immediately after coughing, the breath is so short as if the whole chest was contracted. What is the remedy? So always immediately after coughing, the breath is so short. So shortness of breath. As if the whole chest was contracted. Answer is arsenicum album. And if you see the John Henry Clark's Dictionary of Practical Materia Medica, you can see in the respiratory organs, arrest of breathing with cough. And also shortness of breath, difficulty of respiration, and some more oppression of the chest and coughing, etc. So this direct line which is mentioned in the remedy or the question is not found in any Materia Medica. If you find it, the exact line, you can comment in the comment section so that it will be a reference for us. 19th question, ill effects of vaccination are covered in. So melandrinum, thuja, silesia, all of these. So whenever and all of this is there and it is an homeopathic subject question, there are high chances for the answer being all of this. This is not a generalization. These are some techniques and tips. If you see a lot of question papers, you can understand this kind of things. So ill effects of vaccination are covered in all of these. Sometimes it will be tricky also. For confusing you, they can give such options like all of these, both A and B like that. So you should be very much clear about the concept. So here, if you see the melandrinum drug from William Borig, common name is grease in horses. And you can see in the first paragraph itself, second line, ill effects of vaccination, tuja, silica and melandrinum. So this kind of comparisons, whenever there are three things, I have already stressed this point whenever I did the AIAPGT mock test series also. Whenever there are three things or two things in the bracket, there is a high chance for making a question with an option all the above and A and B, B and C like that. So these things, bracket remedies you have to see, and Borig Materia Medica first paragraph, again I am repeating, it is very very important. So next, if you see efficacious in clearing the remnants of calcareous cancerous deposits, melandrinum again, and copper is also there. So this kind of important and interesting symptoms are there in the first paragraph. So if you see Thuja occidentalis, Arbor Vitae, one of the interesting common name in Materia Medica, Arbor Vitae, tree of life. So ill effects of vaccination again comes here in Thuja. So in Silesia, silica, if you see ill effects of vaccination. So pure flint is the common name of silica, Silesia. Then 20th question, the last question of today's episode. Sensation as if a drop of urine is rolling continuously along the channel is seen under the drug. So very interesting sensation. So this kind of sensations whenever you find in Allen's keynote or Borig, you can separately write it down and do multiple revisions and get more closer to that remedy and make it a point that you know it. Even in sleep, if someone asks, you can answer such sensations. So sensation as if a drop of urine is rolling continuously along the channel is seen under the drug. Answer is Staphysagria. So there will be some confusing close running remedies. So you cannot make a wild guess. If you know the concept, if you know the symptom, you can answer. The answer is Staphysagria. If you see Borig's Materia Medica urinary section, sensation as if a drop of urine were rolling continuously along the channel, this is a symptom. So we have completed 20 questions from Materia Medica section. Today we have done 10 questions. So if you have not watched the previous episodes in this UPSC series, you can watch them. And also you watch the AAPGT mock test series revision series and also the mnemonic series and also Borick's 10-in-1 series, where 100 remedies from Borick's Materia Medica, the important symptoms are covered and you will get an essence of that drug also. It will help you in practice also. So all the episodes which we have already published in our channel are very, very important, and we are very glad that many questions in the AABGD 2020 question paper we could find it, which we have already discussed in our channel. So thank you for supporting us by subscribing and share with your friends about our channel, Friend of Health. Thank you.